Well, I thought after yesterday, you know, the political parties seeing the feedback from many of our viewers would stop, that the BJP and the Congress party would stop. And the expectation, general expectation was that, you know, this personal fight would be less. But look here, it's actually getting worse. Here's the latest. A great evil stalks our land, says Manish Tiwari. And I don't even want to get into what Ajay Makan said there. Sanjay Jha, welcome. Pawan Kumar Varma, representing the JDU point of view, advisor to Nitish Kumar, welcome. Siddharth Nath Singh of the BJP, good to see you back. Jai Narayan Vyas, if I'm not mistaken, has been irrigation minister at one point of time in Gujarat. And therefore, it'd be interesting what he says on the charge that the Prime Minister does not allow the Sardar Sarovar project to be completed. Political editor of the Open magazine, Hartosh Singhbal, doesn't mince his words. Many people don't like Hartosh because he doesn't mince his words. And that's good reason to have Hartosh on the program tonight. And Ashok Malik, senior journalist and columnist, great to see you tonight. Gentlemen, do we begin?
Floor is yours.
The floor is mine. Never say that. No politician should say that to me, Sanjay. I'll take the entire floor and walk away with it.
And we'll be floored as usual, yeah.
Okay. So, Siddharth Nath Singh, a great evil stalks our land. The irony of history is fascists and totalitarianism invariably usurp power through democracy. They subvert it totally. A great evil stalks our land. The latest coming in from the Congress party, including several charges here that your party is involved in intimidating a journalist who wrote an article criticizing the RSS and wrote on the article, that issue was picked up today. So Siddharth Nath Singh, the Congress party seems to have successfully put you on the back foot tonight.
No, I think, Arnab, the facts are very different. The Hindu editor, political editor Venkatraman, has come out openly, made a statement and said they came, 3-4 people from RSS came, they wanted to meet the editor, they met the editor and then they left. There was no vandalism. Now that's a fact which has come from the Hindu. Now there are three more things which I would like to point out and show that how the Congress wants to gag the media. Emergency is well known. Second, if you recall, in May 2012, Meenakshi Natarajan, the close aide of Rahul Gandhi, through a private bill.
No, don't change the subject, Siddharth. Siddharth on top. First of all, let us be absolutely clear. The journalist in question has written the article. She has told a fellow reporter to lodge a complaint. She has spoken about receiving threats from the RSS or people associated with the RSS. So don't dodge that part. I'm asking you today, are you ashamed of what happened?
I have not dodged.
Are you ashamed of the manner in which the journalist was threatened and that she was forced?
No,
anybody who does not agree with your views gets that kind of treatment?
Arnab, I'm sorry. I am just quoting what Mr. Venkatraman of the Hindu has said, quote unquote, on phone to Hindustan Time. And I'm repeating that. Now, beyond this, if there is something, let the investigation happen and we'll all
interjection,
talk about
I'm
it.
Allowing an but interjection, Siddharth. Sanjay Jha is interjecting you on this particular case. We must settle it.
Siddharth, a simple question. Firstly, thanks for making a confession on national television that three RSS people landed up in the office.
I'm sorry, you
are One minute.
Today in the newspaper, there is an INB report. You have to allow me. There is an INB report where the INB has warned that you cannot draw parallels when the Prime Minister is speaking from the Red Fort, or there is a Prime Minister independent speech and you show other leader's speech word by word. And if you do that, there is going to be a punishment, and the punishment is
I first want to say this here. I will say this fairly squarely and clearly. Anyone, any politician, or anyone who claims a link to a political party and who thinks that they can threaten the media, threaten the journalists, call them on the phone, threaten them or insult them or warn them should be ashamed of themselves. And I want to tell you, Siddharthnath Singh, that a case under Section 506 of the Indian Penal Code has been registered on the basis of a complaint lodged by Vidya Subramaniam. The police is probing it, and assistance of the Tamil Nadu police is being sought. And for your information, Siddharthnath Singh, from my information, it is a non-cognizable offence, I am told. But that does not take away from the fact that a case has been registered, so please check your facts. Well, check your facts.
Insisting, then let me read out something for you also.
Check Mr. your facts.
Arnab Goswami,
Mr. Siddharth
Singh, the Hindu Tamil Nadu Bureau Chief, Mr. K. Venkatraman said, four to five people came to the Coimbatore office and insisted on meeting the editor of the Tamil Hindu newspaper. They left after that.
What has that got to do with threats a journalist receives?
There was any vandalism in the office.
What does that?
Who's going to take word?
One sec. We'll take two points.
Can you answer?
Hartosh wants to come in actually.
Mr. Siddharth Singh, a simple question. Question: did those RSS people went to meet Mr. Venkatraman to have a whiff of some great coffee being made in the Hindu office? Please respond to the question being asked. Well, it's there in the public domain. And in the public domain, there is a case registered. Now, please, for God's sake, don't try and dodge an issue which is about intimidation of a journalist, which the RSS is very famous for. We know the entire country knows what your government of the NDA did to the Tehelka magazine because they exposed you in the defense scam. So this is, you got a history. You got a history of intimidating the media, and it is not an unknown fact, which is the reason why Mr. Ajay Makan wrote a letter to the Home Minister expressing his apprehension. That you are capable, your party is capable, your Mr. Narendra Modi is capable of muzzling the media. By the way, this is a known fact. Please don't deny the truths.
One second.
Mr. Sanjay Jha, your today in the newspaper, if you don't need read newspaper, please do that. There is a report that the INB ministry has said we will withdraw license of those channels who show the Prime Minister's speech and compare with any other leader. Isn't this muzzling? What about the emergency? What about the Meenakshi Natarajan's private bill which was introduced? A seven-member
Nobody is threatening a journalist.
Okay, 1 minute.
Of physical violence. Excuse me, Siddharth, don't try and be clever here. Nobody is talking about threatening an Arnab Goswami with physical violence.
Nobody
is talking about intimidation.
You want to?
No, 1 minute. Nobody is here talking about giving all kinds of threats.
Who has said
Mr. Siddharthnath Singh,
gentlemen,
it's about time you calm down, took a deep breath.
Gentlemen,
recognize that you're taking your country for a ride.
First of all,
you're on national television. Speak with some responsibility.
Gentlemen,
speak with responsibility.
Gentlemen, I first.
The word fascist.
Gentlemen, in the run up to.
This is fascism.
In the run up to 2014, let it be known that the media is fairly united and knows how to protect its turf and anybody.
I'm glad.
And anybody here who tries to intimidate a journalist, threaten a journalist, warn a journalist, or, you know, try and walk into a media office and threaten someone, will be answerable to the constitution of this country.
The public of India. And I hope the people who are watching Times Now program can see the risk they are taking with a party like
But.
The risk of having Bhartiya Janata Party obvious to the whole public.
But, Sanjay Jha, while I am touched, I don't forget. Do we forget, Hartosh, what happened on the 26th of June 1976 when the Indira Gandhi government used the Defence of India Rules 1971 to impose the censorship order? Have we forgotten the media blackout during Operation Blue Star? Have we forgotten the attempt to pass the postal bill? Have we forgotten what happened with the defamation bill? Have we forgotten the draft Broadcasting Services Regulation Bill 2006? And have we forgotten what Meenakshi Natarajan, Congress MP as a private individual, tried to push through the Print and Electronic Media Standards and Regulation Bill? What was the basic attempt? I mean, I don't think any journalist thinks here that, Hartosh, that the political parties are our best friends. But I find it interesting today that the whole issue of freedom of expression was turned into a political subject here when the journalist in question, by the way, Hartosh, had not asked the Congress party to bat for her. Vidya Subramaniam did not tell the Congress party to bat for her.
No, she did not.
She
can take suo moto action. By the way,
Arnab, if I may come in before the politician starts speaking again.
Ajay Makan,
he's rebutting.
As a responsible member of the Congress party,
Sanjay, please.
Has a right to speak on behalf of anybody.
Sanjay, and the journalist who has a right to speak tonight, Hartosh.
Arnab, the interesting fact here is you pointed out the number of times the politicians have attempted to muzzle the press.
Oh, yes.
We must make sure we do not succumb again.
Absolutely.
And hearing Mr. Jha and Mr. Siddharthnath Singh speak, the only conclusion I can draw is while the trade charges, it seems clear that both parties have made attempts. And when this can find ways and means, they will try and muzzle the press. It is up to us to resist that pressure. And all the incidents that they have cited are but examples of one political party or the other. Sometimes it is crude and direct, where they actually approach a journalist. They can approach an owner. They can talk about sources of funding. But the fact is, in this divisive election, we will see much more of this. And we will see both political parties already getting into this attempt. And it is up to us to resist it.
Well, I think that point is well made. Then let's get Ashok also into the debate. I mean, after all, the same Congress party that talks about right-wing groups threatening journalists, if I'm not mistaken, blocked the Twitter accounts of journalists in August 2012, those who were seen to be anti-government. You know, the fact remains, doesn't it, Ashok, that the Congress also resorted to censorship of the social media when it didn't suit its needs. This happened as, you know, I think a few months back, Ashok.
But that was
I find it touching.
That was
interesting.
A sensitive case.
No, one second.
And it was immediately withdrawn. When
No. Journalists.
Let's not compare apples and oranges.
I'm not.
Threat of violence. This is trying to suppress somebody's freedom to express.
Ashok Malik.
This is targeting an individual.
Thank you, Ashok Malik.
This is Narendra Modi's
Can
language.
I speak Sanjay jha?
Sabko safai karo.
Thank you, Ashok Malik. Thank you for your touching.
Can I speak, Sanjay jha? Can I please speak?
Yes, Mr. Malik.
Look, various political parties and various governments in this country, including not just the BJP and the Congress, but the CPM as well, have tried to muzzle the press at various points. The Congress, having ruled the longest, has the worst, most egregious record in this matter, from the emergency to the postal bill to the defamation bill to its hysterical views on social media to everything. But I have one question to ask. If any journalist, Vidya Subramaniam or otherwise, is threatened on the phone, or if people land up to threaten her or cause violence in an office, if indeed that has happened, then it is certainly deplorable and action needs to be taken against the individuals or the organization if it is proven that they represent an organization. This action should be taken in Delhi by the Delhi Police Commissioner, and the Home Minister of India should give us a report. If it's in Coimbatore, it should be conducted by the Tamil Nadu Home Minister, and he should give us a report. Who is Ajay Makin to sit in judgment? And why is the Home Minister of India quiet? If this is such a serious matter, why isn't the Home Minister telling us who is guilty, rather than have Ajay Makin speaking at a party forum? I don't understand.
Well, it's a good point. What is if the journalists are not to be torn between political turf, are they? Pawan Verma.
Ajay Makan is a responsible member of the Congress party. And by the way, we have shown here great initiative in supporting a journalist who's being targeted. Nothing in our laws that prohibits me from helping you tomorrow.
He's just been disproven by the journalist.
1 minute, Sanjay. Yes, Ashok.
Responsible member? He's hysterical.
Congress shows initiative in banning the social media.
1 minute.
Shows initiative by bringing a private member bill. Congress shows an initiative if the Prime Minister's speech is compared by any electronic channel with another leader of the in India. So
absolutely.
Congress shows a lot of initiative.
Absolutely.
And they refuse to comment on any one of them, what they are doing. And when there is a political editor who has already quoted to Hindustan Times or other newspapers that there was no vandalism, but still they want to go ahead and make this into an issue,
let's not go into what the Congress does with right to the news channel.
Pawan Verma, 20 minutes into the debate. Let's get the others in. Jenna and Vyas hasn't spoken yet. I'm going to get him in a minute. But before that, Pawan Verma, you know, the same government drew flak for Section 66A of the IT Act. The same government was very sensitive to criticism and humor and tried to regulate content over the internet. In any case, the same government today says we are at the forefront of fighting for Vidya Subramaniam because she's being attacked by certain, you know, RSS forces. My question to you, Pawan Verma, is do you think the Congress party is deliberately shifting its strategy from the communalism issue to the fascist one? So they want all examples to prove their fascist argument there. They want to say that Modi's rise will lead to a totalitarian regime. Yes, 1 second. Let's open up this one.
Arnab, since I know basically both the Congress and the BJP are dying to get at their throats again, I'm going to just make 3 or 4 points. The first is that there is a link between communalism and fascism, especially if the use of religion is done to promote fascism. There's an established historical linkage in this. It can be verified on many occasions. Secondly, it's extremely deplorable in any form to muzzle the press. Let me say to you, as a historian and a writer, political parties and governments have often made the attempt, but it's the strength of the media and that of the public opinion which is the biggest bulwark. Now, if there has been an attempt, and these reports have to be verified, I am myself following them, but if there is an attempt by men of the RSS or cadre of the RSS to intimidate a journalist, it's highly deplorable. But I can say to you on this channel today, I am not surprised. If there could be a responsible member of the BJP who could say that Mr. Amartya Sen's Bharat Ratna should be taken away for the mere fact that he expressed an opinion which was not in compliance with that of the BJP, and the manner in which he was vilified, including through personal attacks. If the prime ministerial candidate of the BJP says in language in a public meeting, chun chun ke saaf karo, which it translates into English, since I know both languages, let us eliminate them one by one. There is a level of intolerance built into the ideology.
Okay.
Which Mr. Pawan Varma doesn't have an experience in making a public speech. That's his problem, it seems.
Oh, don't get personal, please, on this one. Don't get personal on this one. No, don't get personal on this one. 1 minute.
When you speak in public, there is a certain language which is used and you cannot translate.
1 minute.
Drawing room
between both of you.
And I would not like to emulate him. And may no politician have that experience.
General Vyas's turn to respond, please.
Mr. Pawan Varma, you're too far to even emulate and think and a visionary like Narendra Modi and his popularity.
So please, thank you so much.
Just come from a bureaucracy.
You can continue with your loyalty. You
hang here. That will be better. But don't try to emulate what Mr. Narendra Modi can do.
But don't make personal attacks.
Speeches and there is a different discourse. I'm sorry, Mr. Pawan Varma. There is a different discourse. When you speak in the public, you don't translate into a drawing room and then criticize.
You can only make personal attacks. You have no brief, you have no agenda, you have no vision.
That an intellectual and a learned man like you, because you have joined JDU, is making these remarks. Had you been a bureaucrat, you would not have made these kind of remarks or a translation.
Siddhartha Singh, can I say one thing to you? Can I ask you one thing, Siddhartha? One second. By the way, one second, Siddhartha. What's going on here? I mean, is it today a classified crime to disagree with your view? Or for that matter, with the Congress view?
No.
We have nothing to say. You can hear the hotline response.
But if somebody is giving a wrong view,
so one second.
I have the right to reply back to him. So
1 minute.
My reply, my right away.
No, I don't think. From my experience, I have said this today. No political party is a friend of the media. The media stands apart and independent from political parties. Not necessarily always in a state of conflict, but certainly not in conformity. And any attempt to co-opt the media must be fought and defeated, as is an attempt to muzzle the media. Now, can I please move on to some facts? Because I believe, one second. Ashok, I'm just coming to you. I feel, can we spend some time questioning some of the facts which both sides have put to each other?
Sure, absolutely.
Are you ready? Jay Narayan Vyas, I'll put the first question to you. Sorry, I'm coming to 25 minutes into the debate, but I'm sorry about that. But here's the question. Are we ready to question some of the facts? Well, my first question goes to Jay Narayan Vyas. Jay Narayan Vyas, Ajay Makan says...
Please go ahead.
No assembly session in Gujarat is complete without throwing opposition MLAs out of the house. And the Gujarat CAG report was not even discussed in the assembly. Why is he saying this? Because he says that your position on these issues is hollow, shallow, and meaningless. Do you agree that factually Mr. Ajay Makan is 100% right?
If you permit me, Arnab, to tell you what is the exact position, this simply exposes Ajay Makan's total ignorance about parliamentary process.
Okay.
CAG report, as and when he comes, as a formality is simply required to be laid on the table of the assembly. It is never discussed. It goes to the Public Accounts Committee via the Speaker. And Public Accounts Committee is headed by a senior member of the opposition, which then, department by department, grill the concerned departments on the remarks raised by the CAG, and in most of the cases, if they are convinced, they drop the remarks and
you're
they
on the back
come up with the final report.
Do I get a feeling
here,
you're on the back?
Here is our report.
Am
that
I right?
Is required.
Am I right that you're on the back?
That is required. Not understand.
Am I right? Am I right?
Don't stop me in the middle. What is required to be discussed? No, not the list. I am explaining to you why Makan is wrong.
No, but is it true
that
or not that in March 2012
the CAG report?
Is it
what
true
is
or not that in March 2012
what is, what
the
is discussed, no, Mr. Arnab Goswami? What is discussed, Mr. Arnab Goswami? Listen to me. Listen to me. What is discussed in the assembly is not CAG report. It is the report presented by Public Accounts Committee, not by the CAG. What are we talking? It shows absolute, total, and even preliminary ignorance of the knowledge of the parliamentary process.
Concealed from the public. Everybody knows the
estimated
amount of corruption in Gujarat in the CAG report is above 36,000 crore.
One second.
Is that why you don't want to discuss that?
That's not Arnab, the difference is, I'll come to the second point if you permit me. I have kept quiet for 25 minutes. You must permit me my turn. This is unfair. I am not here to listen to all kinds of comments which are irrelevant. Let me
don't lose your temper.
Second thing, if you are talking about Ajay Makan, his press note is totally packed of lies. I tell you, he has said one of the things that Human Rights Commission does not exist in Gujarat. Now, he doesn't know that this commission is fully with the three members and headed by nothing less than the former Chief Justice of Bihar, Justice Bhatt. And it has another two
don't
members.
Don't move the subject.
One,
I'll come to the Human Rights Commission issue when I want.
Judiciary.
No, 1 minute. Now
Mr.
I'm going
Sina,
to interrupt.
Who is
no, no, one second, please. I'm capable
member.
Of interrupting
so
him.
It is
Sanjay Jha, please.
Absolutely wrong.
Sanjay Jha, please.
To say,
one
and I mean, totally away from the facts to say, this is what is Ajay Makan.
Mr. Jha Makan.
This is what is Ajay Makan.
You see, one
and this is what is the validity of
what is going on.
If you are going to rely upon that.
Jai Narayan Vyas, please. You know, I know you can hear me. You're pretending you can't hear me, but hear me. Please hear me. You can hear me. And I can hear you. So you
no, I listen
allow
you loud
to
and clear, Arnab.
Thank you.
I don't pretend.
Thank you. No.
Please go ahead.
Please
go ahead. It's your
one
privilege.
Second, please. I'm just making one small point. Don't react to that. I asked you a question. That is Ajay Makan right in saying that the assembly session of Gujarat happens with opposition MLAs out of the house and the Gujarat CAG report not discussed in the assembly? Why am I going into details? I want to explain this to our viewers. I am going into details because I believe that today a lot of charges are being hurled to get attention, to get rhetoric, to get audience attention. They are not based on fact. No, 1 minute, Mr. Jha, Mr. Vyas, 1 minute. Don't get angry. I will question everything today. Everything. I question the other side also.
Why are you being impatient, Arnab?
I am not impatient, sir.
I am listening to you. I am neither angry. I am as comfortable as you may be sitting in that hot seat. I have absolutely no anger.
I'm thankful.
I have not learned to be angry on some false
thank
charges.
You. I'm happy you're comfortable. I'm comfortable. You're okay and I'm okay. The question, the fact is in March 2012, it is true that
absolutely.
The Gujarat government suspended the entire opposition from the state assembly to ensure that the tabling of the CAG report, which was critical of the Gujarat government. Now I move to question number two. Look at the Congress party. One second. Now let's expose the Congress party. The Congress party says...
No, let me answer, Arnab. Now you have made your point. Now you have made your point. Let it not go uncontested. Are you trying to tell me, Arnab Goswami, tell to the nation that the assemblies are run by the governments? Assemblies are not run by the government. Assembly is run by the speaker. Assembly is run by the members in the house. Assembly is not run by... So government of Gujarat cannot throw somebody out of the assembly. Government has no business to do that.
There's only one thing.
This is a blatant lie.
There's I don't lie. You know, I live in a real world, not a theoretical world. Now,
no,
I want to say something to the Congress.
Said it.
No, one second. Fine. Okay. Fine. You're okay, I'm okay. That's the rule tonight. I'm asking a question to the Congress party. Do I have your permission, Jayanarayan Vyas, to ask a question to the Congress party? You are tonight so angry that it seems you will take over my job.
My
question to the Congress party is this. The Congress...
It's Mr. Vyas permission,
No, one sec. Yeah. The Congress says... Listen here. The Congress says that, you know, it's so terrible that there is no fully functioning state human rights commission in Gujarat. So terrible. Now, Sanjay, how hypocritical. How totally hypocritical. The Maharashtra Human Rights Commission, and you are in Mumbai, did not have a chairman for more than 18 months. It finally got one in September. Hello, who are you to preach to on the other side?
Well, let me tell you.
No, who are you to preach to the other side? Is it true that the Maharashtra Human Rights Commission did not have a chairman for more than 18 months? Should that also be said by Ajay Makan in the course of his statement today that they don't do their job, we don't do our job either? Would you admit that?
He's not commenting on the various positions.
First of all, am I right or wrong?
He's commenting on the issue of Gujarat. I think that's what we need to
focus
on. And I want to make a point here to what Mr. Vyas is saying.
You answer my question.
No, 1 minute.
You answer my question.
You
can't hear Arnab because it is me speaking, Mr. Vyas.
If you allow Arnab,
if you're silent, you can hear me. My question is...
No, why? One sec. Sanjay Jha, I'm interrupting you.
Yeah.
I'm interrupting. You see, may I please take back...
No, you are not the anchor, Mr. Sanjay Jha. Don't take up Arnab Goswami's place.
I completely forgot
His job will be in difficulty.
Can I apologize to you, Mr. Vyas?
You see, there's
please.
A... One second.
No, I'm not. Since you are assuming that role, I'm just politely and humbly reminding you.
What's going on here tonight? One second. Please, between both of you gentlemen, please, you know, I'll get sandwiched. But Pawan Verma, look at what's going on here. Look at Ashok. Ashok Malik, look at what I am only saying.
I think the entire fascist story is based on Sardar.
You can't tell me what
in
I should look at.
Broad daylight without wearing a mask. There's a robbery going on. It's not appropriation.
When I was a child,
the way the BJP is trying to hijack Sardar Patel, I think is an ultimate joke.
You know,
I think this country should stand up.
Sanjay, have you finished?
Advertisement of Narendra Modi.
It is not anybody's monopoly. Yeah. Sardar Patel is country's legacy. Yeah. It is not monopoly of Congress either.
I request you. Sanjay, if you don't stop.
Please also acknowledge that he banned your RSS for creating an environment.
Now, Sanjay, you must.
No question of hijacking anybody.
Now, one second.
You have not taken patent of Mr. Sardar
in government for last 10 years.
1 minute.
What happened? Why didn't you ban us?
Please.
You have been in government for last 10 years. Why didn't you ban RSS if that's the case?
1 minute. May I come in?
So stop making rhetoric, Mr.
First of all, why RSS was called at the Republican parade in 1963?
Please, Sanjay.
For last 10 years.
Please, Sanjay. Please, I request you. First of all, I request. We have some time. And why is everybody getting so hassled when I'm saying I'm going to expose every point of view tonight? I'm exposing points of view. I don't believe, Artosh, in, you know, this has gone on for too long. You know, everything
Arnab,
that a politician says is...
After your question, give time to everybody to speak.
Arnab.
Yeah, if I... No. I'm saying Lokayukta. Let me give one more example, Pawan Verma. Lokayukta. Now, they say that the Gujarat Lokayukta doesn't do its job, etc. So you've got a lot of peeves against the Lokayukta. The Maharashtra Lokayukta, according to RTI reports, has not launched a single probe since 2007. 1,680 complaints went unattended. You don't launch a single case since 2007. So say that the BJP does not let a Lokayukta function, neither do...
That's for the Lokayukta to answer. How can we interfere
well,
with
that? Sure you
but
can't.
At least our Lokayukta has got powers, unlike the Gujarat government.
Don't...
Where Narendra Modi...
Pawan Verma coming back...
...tries to hide his own by weakening his own state apparatus. It's a joke.
The Lokayukta is sitting idle like a lame duck in Maharashtra.
Sanjay Jha, 1 minute.
Congress's style of working.
I get it. Hartosh Singh Bal into the debate. Hartosh... You know, when the problem is we are not looking at things in detail. When you look at things in detail, you actually realize that a lot of the rhetoric is fluff. Don't you?
Arnab, we are seeing an election of competing half-truths. And these politicians in today's debate is emblematic. They are so self-obsessed and so involved in shouting at each other that they don't believe that people standing outside this debate can actually see the farce for what it is. And this is how this campaign is unfolding. This is how this discussion is unfolding.
I completely agree with you. And now can I go to the subject which is being raised here, the Sardar Sarovar project, right? Narendra Modi said today, Pawan Kumar Varma, let's get you in first. Do you think Narendra Modi is correct when he said today that the Prime Minister he has met a dozen times regarding the Sardar Sarovar project and that there is a political interest that the Congress party has in delaying the gate installation which would complete the Sardar Sarovar project overnight, but only if the centre took the politics out of it? I want Pawan Varma's perspective first on it. Pawan Varma.
I won't answer.
You can answer after.
First of all, Arnab, I must confess that I'm not fully au courant with the exact subject. Mr. Modi has made an allegation. I do not know its veracity, but I can say this to you completely without reservation. There is no doubt that there are many proposals which come from state governments, which are pending at the center and long delayed, and this is a governance malfunction.
Yes, Jainarayan Vyas.
If it's true, then it's true.
Arnab, I'll be absolutely technical on this issue. Let me tell you that in last 2 decades, there is highest flood in 1998 of 22 lakh cusacks. Even during that flood, nothing which is now being talked about to be inundated has got inundated. Now, if you permit the gates to be raised, it will take 3.5 years' time. And nothing is going to go wrong. You don't permit if you feel and there is any even iota of doubt regarding resettlement. I would fully admit the first right of the people who are required to be rehabilitated, it should not be permitted to get, the gates should not be permitted to get closed down. Now, anybody on technical grounds, administrative grounds, would be able to say this decision subject to the condition that we will not permit you to close the gates. You construct the gates, we will take 3.5 years' time. Ultimately, who will be the beneficiary? The electricity that will be getting generated, 1450 megawatts of power, Gujarat is only getting 16% out of it. 84% goes to the nation. Now, who is losing? Who is losing this precious power when we are passing through a difficult situation of balance of payment? Importing the fuel.
Who is getting disadvantage?
It is the nation which suffers. This is not Gujarat's project. This is a national project.
Why did you remember it today? Because you wanted to draw that similarity between the Sardar Sarovar project on one side and the inauguration of the Sardar Patel statue on the other.
My arguments have remained constant.
Let him complete. One of the most indebted states in India. What have you done with the funds that you have received from the central government?
One second. Hartosh, I'm allowing Hartosh. Sanjay, please stop. Hartosh.
Don't mislead the nation, Mr. Vyas.
Arnab. If Mr. Jha will let me speak, I know something about this project. I followed it very closely. And one of the shames of this project is the kind of rhetoric Mr. Vyas and Mr. Modi continue to use.
Yes.
They focus on the building of the gates when the truth is, again,
this is not rhetoric.
What
these are facts.
Is a half truth.
These are facts. You
let,
come back with the facts.
Let me finish, Mr. Vyas. What I am saying
is you debate the facts. Don't say rhetoric. This is not a rhetoric.
If you let him speak the facts.
That is due to Gujarat from the dam goes waste because Gujarat has not been able to build the canals that are necessary to take the water to the farmers. 70% of the
it's
canal
a blatant lie. It's a blatant lie. It's a blatant lie. It's a blatant lie. This is devoid of facts. You are making, you know, today, even today,
let him complete, Mr. Vyas. You don't like it when someone interrupts you. You don't like it when someone interrupts you. So he has a right to
complete. Why are you telling 90% is going waste?
Let him.
Why are you telling 90% is going waste?
If he disagrees,
utilizing out of 80 lakh which are required to develop.
If he disagrees with you,
5 lakh hectares are already given the water.
Mr. Vyas,
and the rest will follow.
Mr. Vyas,
why are you telling 90%?
Mr. Vyas,
it is wrong.
Mr. Vyas,
because
1 minute.
That is the truth, Mr. Vyas.
It
Mr.
Is
Vyas,
absolutely wrong. Come to Gujarat. I'll come with you. I am taking this challenge in this open debate. I'll come with you and show we are irrigating 5 lakh hectares and not 10% what you are talking.
Now, Mr. Vyas, can I say one thing to you?
Mr.
Please,
Vyas,
1 minute, Hartosh. Hartosh, 1 minute.
That is your wisdom.
Hartosh, 1 minute.
You don't know the plight of people of Gujarat and their priorities.
I just want to, Mr. Vyas, 1 minute.
No, that is your wisdom.
Hartosh, 1 minute. You know, I'll tell you. Hartosh, 1 minute and yeah. Mr. Vyas, 1 minute.
I am going to say something here.
Please listen to me. You see, the question here is this. Look what's happening, sir. I'm really getting worried, by the way. I get a feeling that today you disagree with a politician and he'll give you hell. You know, you can't disagree. Now, I'm sorry, but you know, you disagree. Your word, last word. Politician's word, last word. The journalist speaks up, he'll be shouted. Someone else speaks up, civil society speaks up, bureaucrat speaks up. Anyone else who disagrees would be outshouted. So, Mr. Vyas, please remember this, that Hartosh, if he has his point of view, he has a right to, he has his own right to have a point of view. He doesn't even need my right to, permission to have his point of view. He has his point of view, let him speak. And by the way, for every technical argument of yours, let him complete. Because, you know, this whole business, what is going on now? People raining insults, all that. Let people disagree with you, please. It's a democracy. Hartosh, please complete. Hartosh, please complete. Hartosh complete, Mr. Vyas. He didn't interrupt you.
Arnab, I'm making the simple point that 70% of the canal network, 4 years after it should have been completed, lies incomplete. And most of this incomplete fieldwork is the field canals which actually take the water to the fields. In effect, none of the irrigation benefits of the Sardar Sarovar Dam.
Arnab, I have the right to rebuttal.
In effect, the cost-benefit ratios on which this project was clear have totally been set aside. The project is a failure on every grounds on which it was cleared because of the failure of the Modi administration to build the necessary canals.
Now, Mr. Vyas, yes. 30 seconds,
absolutely
respond.
Absolutely. Arnab, now let my words be not watered down by you or the others as words of politicians. I am speaking to this on this subject as an IIT trained engineer who has full knowledge and competence to talk what he is talking. I am telling
you. Yeah, but you are not the last
one,
word. You know
this
what?
Is totally
no, you are
fact.
Not the last
Mr.
word.
Mr. Hartosh.
You are not the last word. No, you are not the last word. No, Mr. Vyas, you are not the last word.
I am not. Let me complete, Arnab. Why have you to intervene me? But why are you intervening?
Because the way you are speaking.
I am just telling Mr. Because there were some wrong things going on record.
You allow a journalist to speak.
Arnab, let us not wipe out facts.
Arnab, you can hear
let us not wipe out facts on somebody's hearsay. Wrong interpretations cannot wipe out the facts.
Today, the world can
the facts are different.
You are intimidating a journalist on TV.
No, I want to reply, Hartosh. Let me complete, Arnab, what I was saying. Why are you not permitting me 2 minutes time?
I'm actually permitting
my argument is half complete.
I'm permitting you, please.
Like the dam is half.
Let him complete, don't heckle.
What I was telling Mr. Hartosh is that from 1956, when the Kakrapar Weir was built in Gujarat, till 2000, there was only 12 lakh hectares Gujarat could bring under irrigation. From 2000 to 2013, after Narmada came, we have gone from what was done in last almost more than 50 years, more than 60% of that has been done in last 10 years. So,
okay,
you know, command area development is not a child's play, it doesn't take place. And with the kind of laws that you have now, acquisition of land is going to be increasingly difficult. It's not going to be that easy.
Since you are an IIT engineer, I also happen to be an MBA, so I'm going to ask you a question. Why is the Gujarat government so indebted? Where is all the money gone?
Please.
Because you have failed on all human development indicators. On infrastructure, you are ranked low. I would assume a dam comes as part of infrastructure. Where is that money gone? Why is the Gujarati so indebted?
Mr. Arnab Goswami, listen to me.
That is not Arnab Goswami, for God's sake. That is Sanjay Jha.
If you so desire, and you are swearing, Arnab,
it's not me, it's Sanjay Jha, for God's sake.
Let me tell you, my PhD thesis is on this subject. Let me tell you, my PhD thesis is on this subject, and I can send you the thesis.
1 minute.
That will answer your query. First, study it and then come up for the debate.
One minute. Can I please? A moment of light relief. You know, I'm sweating. One sec. The question is, Mr. Vyas, for your kind information.
Don't swear by your MBAs.
One second. I'm not an MBA, and this is not Sanjay Jha. This is me. And you are hearing me where, you know, that's the problem, Mr. You are premeditated. Your person speaking to you was Sanjay Jha.
Because I don't have the benefit. I don't have the screen before me, Arnab.
That's all right.
And in this, the kind of...
that's all right.
That prevails, I'm not able to listen.
That's all. By the way, my last point tonight, Mr. Ajay Makan expresses anguish at the way the Gujarat Assembly was functioning when it came to tabling CAG reports. I don't know. Is this the same Congress party, Pawan Verma, which repeatedly attacks the very institution of the CAG? Repeatedly slams his comments, talks about the CAG's brazenness, says the CAG has maligned India's image internationally, questioned the government's authority. Pawan Verma, is that hypocrisy?
Can
you
come in after?
No, first Pawan Verma. First Pawan Verma.
Let me give you a straight answer, Arnab. First of all, for a government which has been accused or before which certain facts have been placed by the CAG is within its rights to question that report, but it is not within its rights to criticize the institution. And whenever that line is blurred, I believe the Congress party or any other party or government is making
wrapping
a mistake.
Up. Okay, so we're wrapping up. Wrapping up at this point.
The Congress party was
first
against
break.
Two factors. One was a leak of a report.
No.
And the second part was
no.
that figures were put which were absolutely unjustified. And
history,
glad the Supreme Court
Sanjay Jha,
later on told the CAG that you cannot assume
an
action.
Final counter from Siddharth Singh. Final counter
so
from Siddharth Nath Singh. Siddharth
Nath Singh. Those figures are wrong.
Siddharth, you attacked the question.
Absolutely.
Not the institution.
In
the way that individual.
Siddharth.
We attacked an individual action in that
institution.
Was fictitious. Why did your minister go into jail? Why a MP went into jail? Why you are hiding behind the JPC, not allowing the Prime Minister to be questioned and Chidambaram to be questioned on 2G? Why under the Colgate, if the report is fictitious, why you are questioning so many industrialists? Why people FIRs are being filed? If the fictitious, if the there is a zero loss theory, then don't do anything.
All
but
we've proven tonight.
Yourself and raising questions on
all,
the cat.
All we've proven tonight, and this is wrapping up last time, taking only 10
this
seconds.
Is Arnab,
on the CAG,
of
Mr.
Congress.
Vyas, let me speak,
double
please.
Double standards and hypocrisy
Mr.
of Congress.
Mr. Vyas,
you are
on the CAG,
BGP.
On the CAG, politicians can't be believed. On the Lokayukta, politicians cannot be trusted. And on defending the media, well, the media is good enough to defend itself. Thank you for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.
But
thank you.
All-